Hey everybody, I just had some quick thoughts, a little Christmas message for you. I have been hearing a lot about how hard it is in the holidays to cope with being divorced or to cope with a different situation. Things are different, I understand. There are traditions, there's activities that the kids count on both of you being together, and now it's different, especially if this is the first year. Or maybe years have gone by. Maybe you're still single. Maybe you're just feeling a little bit more lonely. And some reason, the holidays bring out the problems and kind of exacerbate them. But I want to change the focus. I really, really hope and wish for you that you can take this holiday as different, and that actually to have these trials during Christmas season is a good thing, and that you can bear them a little easier as we focus on its true meaning, whatever that is to you. For me, it is the birth of the Savior, Jesus Christ. And if you have a similar belief, trying to emulate his life, trying to give, trying to live as he lived, will truly help you during the season be able to cope even better. So it's a little bit ironic if you can go with me with it just for a little bit. In the New Testament, it says, "He who loseth his life for my sake shall find it." That's Christ speaking. We know that when we lose ourselves in the service of others, we actually find ourselves. And it's true in general, doing good things. When we forget about ourselves and our own problems, we're focused on other people, that's where happiness and growth can truly take place. So I am really hoping that this season you can try to forget about your problems. Let Christ take them from you and create new traditions and new hope and new giving and service outside of yourself. The first thing I hope for you is that you can give the gift of being happy with your situation for your children. We all know that when mama's happy, or if you're a single dad and you're around your kid, when the parent is happy, it's a huge reflection on the children. They emulate our mood. They mirror us in everything we do. I have a daughter who, for some reason, does not like going to Mexico. Now, my husband, all his family are in Mexico, so we go often. And it's a struggle. She's 13 and she doesn't want to go. But if I have a bad attitude about it, it makes it worse. But if I say, "Oh my gosh, we're gonna do a lot of fun things, it's gonna be great," then her attitude changes. And we know this for everything. So I encourage you that as you're becoming okay with the situation, and I know it can be a process, but even if you fake it in front of your kids, it can do wonders for them. You're gonna say, "We're gonna do these new traditions. You still have us in your lives, it's just different. And it's gonna be great. We're gonna serve. We're gonna do something together." I heard a story recently about a Syrian woman with six children in a refugee camp. And they've lost everything. They've lost family members, they've lost their home. And she was talking to a reporter about what she does to keep her kids' spirits up. And she invents games for them to do. She has them go collect rocks and tell her what the rocks look like. You know, just dolls or horses or animals or whatever. She has small children. We can do this with small children. We can create things. We can make it, you know, exciting and magical. Children are resilient. They're thinking of themselves a lot. And we can paint a beautiful, beautiful picture for them, but we have to be aware that we can do that and that we are doing that, or maybe we're not, and we can change it. Now, the teenager is a little bit different. They're very self-centered and very focused on themselves. But I think back to myself, I really was thinking about everything I had to do. And in tough situations, yeah, it was hard. And there were changes. But it's really a little bit easier than we think. We have an attitude of, oh, they're going through all of this. And are they going to be okay? And I'm so worried. Actually, they are. They are, because it's supposed to happen. And they'll be better people because of it. I can promise you that. And as you are the reflection, as you give out that light, as you are okay with it, even if you're faking it at first, fake it till we make it, and you're happy with the traditions you're going to start and you're doing these things, they will see it in you and they will mirror it. I promise you that. So I hope that you can give that to your children and that it will actually be giving it back to yourself. You'll feel that. And then I touched on it a little bit in the beginning, but as you lose yourself in focusing on others, other people's problems, we always know there's other people with deeper, stronger, more painful problems than our own. We don't want to compare problems. I don't like doing that either, but we can help. We can be there for people. We can lift. We can. There's so many opportunities. So I hope that for you this Christmas season, I hope you can feel the Savior's love, or whoever you believe, the higher power love that there is for you, and that you are awesome and you can do this, and it can be the best, most magical Christmas and season ever. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and take care. Bye.